Good evening. Our story begins...
Marley was dead.
Excuse me?
That's how the story begins.
No, it's not.
How about 'twas the night before?
No.
Maybe I want to live, Clarence.
Not even close. We're telling the Christmas story, not just a Christmas story.
Oh, the Christmas story. You mean the one where an angel tells Mary she's going to give birth to a savior, and she and Joseph go to Bethlehem, but there's no room at the inn, and they stay in a stable, named baby Jesus, and he sleeps in a manger, and an angel tells the shepherds to find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes. I don't know what that is. Have you ever swaddled? Three wise men follow a star and visit King Herod, and they show up at the stable, give gifts, and everybody sings joy to the world. You mean that story?
Well, yes.
Hope you enjoyed it. Good night, everybody.
Wait a minute.
I told the story. Isn't that the idea?
You can't just rush through the story like that.
Why not? Come on, dinner's getting cold.
Because you have to understand what the people felt like in the story. Remember? They were people, just like us.
You mean they were hungry?
Think about it. How would you feel if an angel of the Lord appeared to you?
Right here?
Yes.
Right now?
Yes.
Is he bringing dinner?
The people in the Christmas story saw things they'd never seen before, like angels and a brilliant star, because that night a special baby was born, just as they had been foretold.
You mean they knew about this ahead of time?
600 years ahead of time.
They had 600 years to get ready?
Yes.
And they still didn't get the Christmas shopping done?
600 years before the birth of Jesus, a prophet named Isaiah foretold the coming of our Savior.
A voice cries in the wilderness, "Make ready the way of the Lord, for unto us a child was born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God."
Then, 600 years later... In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Hail, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at saying, and considered in her mind what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son. You shall call his name Jesus."
"Hail, O favored one, the Lord is with you."
Oh, wow, an alien!
I'm not an alien, I'm an angel.
Like, there's a difference?
There are plenty of differences.
Name one.
There are plenty of differences.
Just one.
All right.
I'm waiting.
Don't rush me.
I bet real aliens tell difference.
I'm not an alien.
You're not?
No, I'm an angel and I'm a messenger from God.
For me? You sure not an alien?
Positive. Here's the message. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus.
I was a lot less scared when I thought you were an alien.
Look, next time I visit, I'll make sure I know the difference between an alien and an angel.
Great, thanks. And when you come back?
Yes.
Could you bring a good way to explain this to my husband?
Hi, Mary. Come look at this new chair I just finished.
That's nice, Joseph, but I have something.
Nice? It's not just nice. It's going to revolutionize chairs.
Joseph, I...
If this catches on in a few years, I just won't be a lowly carpenter. I'll be a furniture entrepreneur.
What is it?
I call it a rocking chair. It's for people who want to sit down and rock gently to sleep.
Most people who want to fall asleep go to bed.
What about people who fall asleep watching television?
What's television?
I don't know, but it sounds like something that'll put you to sleep. Now, was that you wanted to tell me?
Maybe you'd better sit down.
When Mary had been betrothed to Joseph, she was found to be with the child of the Holy Spirit, and her husband Joseph, being a just man and unwilling to put her to shame, resolved to divorce her quietly. But as he considered this, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. When Joseph woke from his sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him.
Joseph!
Oh my gosh, an alien!
Not an alien!
Are you sure?
Yes. An alien is someone from another planet who eats your Reese's Pieces and makes your bicycle fly.
Oh, of course you're not an alien. You're something that materializes in the middle of the night and scares the dickens out of me.
No, that would be a ghost.
You're a ghost.
No, I'm an angel. I'm a messenger from God.
God has a message for me?
Yes.
I bet it's about the rocking chair, isn't it?
What?
You're going to tell me how to fix the squeaking, right?
No. Here's the message. Joseph, son of David, do not fear to take Mary your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins.
That's it?
That's it.
I was a lot less scared when I thought you were a ghost. I was thinking.
What?
Do you know what this rocking chair would be good for?
No.
Say I'm holding a baby and the baby's crying. I rock a little, the baby gets relaxed. I sing a little and the baby goes to sleep.
You would do that?
I'd be happy to.
Who could that be?
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to be enrolled, each to his own city.
Yes?
Hello, may I ask a few questions?
Of course.
Your name?
Mary.
Your name?
Joseph.
Number of people in this household?
2.3.
Uh-huh. Husband's hometown?
Bethlehem.
Thank you, good day.
That's it?
I'm afraid not. You have to return to your hometown for the enrollment.
Enrollment?
Haven't you heard? In these days, there is a decree out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled.
We hadn't heard.
What's this about my hometown?
You have to return to Bethlehem for the enrollment.
But my wife's going to have a baby in a few weeks.
Then you better hurry.
And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you. help you?
Yes, it's our room.
Oh, yes, Mr.
Joseph.
Oh, yes. What seems to be the matter?
Well, it's our room.
Not big enough?
No, plenty big.
Not small enough?
No, the size is perfect.
Then what seems to be the matter?
Well, there are no beds, there's straw everywhere, and there are animals.
Animals?
Cattle, sheep, goats. Cattle, sheep, horses, I think I saw a couple goats.
Goats?
A couple.
Well, what seems to be the matter, Mr. Joseph, is...
Yes?
That all of our rooms have animals in them.
All of them?
Oh, yes, yes. Well, most of the people enjoy the comfort of God's creatures.
They do?
Oh, yes. Our royal suite has a family of rhinoceros, and our penthouse has a brood of wombats.
Oh.
Otherwise, the accommodations would be acceptable.
Well, I just would have brought it up, but my wife just had a baby.
A baby? Congratulations. Boy or girl?
Boy.
And the little lad's name?
Jesus.
Wonderful. That'll be another $350 a night.
$350 a night?
Additional purpose in the room. It's on your rate card.
Swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill."
Let me see.
Tex, what do you call that tune?
Nothing, just a little something that came to me.
Be not afraid.
Great jumping polecats! An alien!
That ain't no alien, that there's an angel.
An angel?
Finally somebody got it.
If you don't mind my asking, Mr. Angel, what brings you out on a night like this?
Be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of a great joy, which will come to all the people. For to you is born this day in the city of David, a Savior who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger.
A manger?
Just a sec.
Hello, narrator department.
Hi, it's me, the angel mobile unit. The angel mobile unit just checking. It's a manger the baby is in?
That's right, a manger.
But a manger, maybe I'm missing something, but a manger is an open bin for feeding horses and cattle. You put hay in a manger, not a baby.
God does things differently than we do. To find the baby in a manger.
If you say so. Yes, a manger.
Glory to God in the highest and on earth. Peace, goodwill to all.
Yahoo!
Yahoo! We better saddle up and get a look-see at this new baby savior. Mr. Angel, do you mind taking care of the sheep?
Sure thing, partner.
When the angels went away to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, in which the Lord has made known to us." And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and a babe lying in a manger. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. But Mary kept all these things, pondering them in her heart, and the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they heard and seen, as it has been told.
Thank you.
Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise people from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he who is born king of the Jews? For we have seen a star in the east and have come to worship him. Herod summoned the wise men secretly and ascertained from them what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, Go and search diligently for the child. And when you have found him, bring me word that I too may come and worship him.
From the east, and we seek the newborn king.
The newborn what?
King, you know, regent, nabob, heir apparent.
I know, fella. There's only one king here, and he hasn't been newborn in a long time.
Well, there must be a newborn king.
We've been bearing gifts and travels afar.
Over field and fountain, moor and mountain.
Calling yonder star.
Star of wonder, star of light. Star of royal beauty bright.
What is that noise?
Wise people from the east, your highness.
I could tell it wasn't the Jonas Brothers.
They seek a newborn king.
Newborn?
You know, newborn, babe in arms, man in soul.
I know what newborn means. I'm afraid you've come to the wrong palace.
But your highness, the star led us to this area.
So it did. If there is a king with a star for a nightlight, he must be very powerful.
Perhaps more powerful than you, mighty Herod.
Perhaps. And if you wise people are very wise.
We are.
And you can find this king for me. But I must be sure you are very wise. You three, step forward.
I think this is trouble.
No. This is Jeffrey. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Nativity's Jeopardy. I'm your host, Herod Jebeck, and here are tonight's contestants.
I'm Einstein from the East, and I study birds and plan to start skydiving as soon as someone invents the airplane.
I'm Newton from the East, and I enjoy water skiing. Of course, I'd enjoy it more if someone invented outboard motor.
I'm Hawking from the East, and I'm an astronomer, and I wish someone would invent the telescope.
Now let's begin. Einstein?
I'll take Bible facts for 100, Herod.
The answer is, this number of kings visited Jesus in the stable.
What is three?
Sorry, trick question. The Bible never says anything about three kings, just wise people from the east. And the Bible never says how many there are. What? You guys aren't so wise. Wait.
Then why does everyone think there's three?
Because the Bible only mentions three gifts. You guys aren't so wise after all.
Come on, give us another chance.
Okay, pick again.
I'll take Change of Pace Christmas Music for 200.
It's a an audio video daily double. How much do you want to risk?
You take traveler's checks?
No. How about if you're wrong, I'll take your camels. And if you're right, I don't know. What do we have for the wise people, Johnny?
If they get this question right, they get gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
The following musical selection is written in this key.
What is D major?
That's correct. That's all the time we have for today, so long till next time. Let me know where you found the baby at.
We're not really going to tell where the baby is, are we?
No, we're wise people, remember?
When they had heard the king, they went on their way, and lo, the star that they had seen in the east went before them, till it came to rest over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary's mother, and they fell down and worshipped him.
By the time they left Bethlehem, all of them, the shepherds, the wise people, and Mary and Joseph had seen something they'd seen 100 times before, a baby. But they all knew they'd seen something they hadn't seen before, God with us.
And that's how the story ends.
The story doesn't end. God's grace for us isn't just 2,000 years old. It's new every day. It may appear in ways we don't expect or in things we see every day, but it's always there.
I know. I said I was hungry before.
Yes.
But could we tell the story one more time?
Okay, one more time.
Give him my heart. What can I give him? But all of my. Let's stand and give them a hand.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah.
May be seated just for a moment. Just for a moment. We got a couple of things to do before we go even any further. We're as a church, we've been in something called the season of blessing, and we've got in the office there are so many people have given gifts to people that don't have anything, and we've had people just give their heart and their time, and because in this season of blessing that we just believe blessing other people. And I'm blessed to see all these kids up here. This is amazing to me to see these children, those who are working with them. And I'm reminded how the Bible says the children are a heritage to the Lord. And even now, I'm reminded about how important it is to give our heart to the Lord. And maybe you're here today, you're a guest with us. Maybe you've been here every Sunday for a long time. Maybe you have a child that's in this. Maybe your heart has not really been totally, fully the Lord's. Can I tell you, this is the greatest season, the greatest day to let Jesus have all of your heart. Let him have everything within you. And so just bow your hearts with me just for a moment. And somehow the Lord's just been speaking to you even during this musical. And you've seen kids up here. And maybe your kids and maybe your grandkids. And the Lord stirred you even now. Would you just right where you are under your breath silently, would you just open your heart right now to the Lord? Would you say this to the Lord? Say, Lord, I believe that you love me. And I believe you were born in a manger. And I believe you died for me. And Lord, I open my heart to you. Lord, give me the peace that I've been looking for. Give me the joy that I've needed. Lord, forgive me for the things I've done wrong. And from this day forward, Lord, help me to live for you and to do what's right. Lord, my life is yours now. And Lord, from this moment forward, let me serve you with everything within me. I pray this, Lord, and I believe this, and ask that you would do a work in my heart from this moment forward. In Jesus' name. Would you head bowed and eyes closed? If you prayed a prayer today to open your heart to the Lord, would you just lift your hand? I'm not going to embarrass you, but just slip your hand up in the air. Thank you. Yes, yes. Anywhere else in the room? Yes, I see that. Yes. Anyone else in the room? You open your heart to the Lord today. Yes, I see that in the back. Yes, open your heart to Jesus. Amen. You can look up now. Pastor Mike's going to come. He's got a few presentations he wants to do and some instructions. We're thankful, so thankful that you're able to allow your kids to be with us. And kids, I want you to know that Pastor Chris wishes he was here, but you know he's in China, and he said he knows you guys are going to do a good job. But we want to show a picture to all the kids who didn't see it earlier, a picture of Pastor Chris's new little boy. Have you seen the little boy yet? He's 1 year old. Would you show it on the video, please, for us? There's Pastor Chris and Miss Donna and their little boy. Their little boy. So they are so happy for you guys. They're so happy for you guys. Pastor Mike.
All right, wonderful job, guys. Hey, many of you know, most of you know, something like this doesn't happen with some great people. Without some great people working behind the scenes, giving their time and energy to something like that. And we just want to recognize some folks today, give them some recognition. I'm going to ask my wife, Lisa, to come help me. And I'm going to help you up here, Lisa. All right, so if you're able, guys, if I call your name, if you just come out, we just want to recognize you. Miss Teresa Baker. She helped us with our music. Miss Courtney Fugate. Great job. Miss Doc Crawford. And last but not least, Miss Heather Bundrick.
This, but now I just want to give a special speech. I want to give a shout out. Just kidding. Thank you.
Great job. Great job. And also, I forgot, the costumes were made by Miss Teresa Denton. She's somewhere back here. So we thank her for doing that. Looks great. All right, parents.
Praying, gold, mirth,
jewelry, and stuff that he really needed.
Guess he brought him gold and other things. I don't know too. I don't know. They brought like jewelry sort stuff.
Gold, Frankenstein, myrrh.
I don't know.
Gold.
There's some other stuff that I don't know.
You're gonna have to get a baby thing with a toy like to have all those little balls in.
I never noticed that because my brain didn't know that.
Gold, frankincense, and myrrh?
Present.
Gold and some other stuff.
Oh no.
The star.
Because it was easy to find Jesus.
An angel showed me the way. But an angel brought Jesus down.
An angel told him.
Can go and find him and walk up and find him.
I'm not very good at seeing my daddy.
I don't know.
No.
I don't know.
I don't know.
A star.
I don't know.
I'm in Bethlehem.
In a manger.
Bethlehem.
In a manger.
I'm not very good at the Jesus part.
In a manger.
Bethlehem.
In heaven.
In the manger.
Bethlehem.
In a manger.
In Bethlehem.
His birthday is on it.
For gifts.
Because it's Jesus' birthday.
Because Jesus was born on that day.
To celebrate Jesus' birthday. Because it's Jesus' birth.
Because.
Celebrate Santa.
That's the day when Jesus started by his birthday. It's a holiday. And that holiday is where baby Jesus got born.
Because that's Jesus' birth.
Because Jesus was born on that day.
Oh no.
Jesus' birth.
I don't really know.
I'm not very good at that one. I hadn't seen one.
I don't know.
Don't know?
I don't know. But it's like the government counting how much people in the country or something.
I don't know.
A new marine suit.
A leather bathing suit.
A motorcycle.
Because he's an FBI agent detective and I am too. I really don't know yet.
Tools.
I think I'll get him a new game for his game at home.
Think a new coffee cup.
Some clothes.
I don't know.
I don't know.
Present is a big horse.
Incredible Hulk shirt and MTP looks like this.
A pink dress.
Flower.
A flower.
Makeup.
I'm thinking about getting her a candle.
I'm either getting her a card or flowers.
I think I'll get her a card or flowers.
Okay. I'm not sure yet.
I think I'm gonna get her a phone, I think. I don't know.
Maybe just a card.
I'm going to try to raise enough money to get her a new iPad.
Necklace.
I don't know.
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle all the way. Oh, my farm is to ride winners up and sleigh. Hey,
I don't have a favorite.
I don't have one.
I don't really know any.
The first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me, and that's all I know.
I don't like Christmas songs, I don't even know any.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth be seen his king. Let every heart prepare his womb. And let heaven and nature sing. And heaven, nature sing.
I need to think again.
I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know. Jesus loves slaves.
I'm not sure if that's a wise man party.
Wise men who are people who go to other people with gifts or something.
They're wise.
They're men who give gifts to Jesus.
They're wise.
People that are brave.
God.
There are three wise people.
Wise people?
People don't have any place to go because they're wise.
He slept on the hay.
Because,
So you want to get stolen?
Or you want to get killed?
Because he didn't want to get taken.
I don't know that either.
Because at the hotel there wasn't any rooms open.
Now that I don't know.
Because he cared about everyone but himself.
Because they didn't have anywhere else to stay.
Because they had nowhere else to put him.
Because they had no place to go. Because the manager at the hotel or something wouldn't let them in.
Because Mary didn't have anywhere else to put him.
I don't know.
Because you have to put lights on it?
Because
I don't know.
The 30th of celebrate Christmas.
So everyone will. So Santa will know which light to go first.
I don't know about that.
To celebrate God's birthday?
I don't know.
To celebrate Jesus' birthday.
Make it look pretty?
I don't know.
To make the Christmas tree seem prettier?
Celebrate stars, the angels, I think angels. I don't know that one.
And walk every
ruled by a camel.
I don't remember.
A camel.
I don't know. Mm-hmm. Airplane style.
They rode on a donkey or a horse.
They rode on a donkey.
They rode a horse.
I don't know. On a donkey.
On a camel.
On a donkey?
Oh.
I think a donkey. Donkey?
A donkey.
Skateboard.
Some new Christmas lights.
A bathing suit.
Lambs. I'm gonna give him a cloud ambulance too so he can go up there and then have a siren so he can just get the stuff on. That's easy.
Love and all. Love and. And not the sin.
Love and money.
Faith. Love and money.
My heart.
Giving to the world vision.
My heart. Feed the hunger. Oh, my heart. My heart.
A band-aid for its movie on the scene.